Stone Talker Markash, you will be treated as a prisoner of the Empire and remain under my guard and protection. You will retain some privileges due to your rank.
You are a Lorn Knight, aren't you? You bear the name of the First Emperor, and yet you chain me like a dog. How ignorant have they made you?
You rebelled against the Empire. You chose your fate.
The Empire was forged by the Great Alliance. The Alliance with all five elemental covenants.
That was centuries ago.
This was 315 years ago. I was there, young knight. I stood by Lorne's side when he heard the Stone Whispers. When Earth Priests became his allies. Allies, not servants, not slaves.
No one lives that long.
Some live much longer than they wish, and others live longer than they should. Why do you think the Empire sent you here?
Because you rebelled against its authority.
No, we rebelled against your nobles. Your so-called nobles who demanded more and more from us, solely for their personal gain. What do you think lies in this deserted place? Vast cities to control? Riches? Food to sustain armies? Nothing. There is nothing of value in the desert of Norlok. Only sand and stones. But some of these stones, they are soul crystals. That's what your scared nobles want.
Soul crystals?
You have never heard of them, have you? You're just a dog sent by his master to bring back a stick. You don't even know the value of that stick. Soul crystals can be used to extend life. Destroying them is sacrilege, and you only regain a few years. But your nobles are so afraid of death that they keep abusing them again and again. So we said, enough. Enough corruption. Enough defiling of our sacred stones. This is not the spirit of the Great Alliance. This is not the Lorn Empire we helped to build.
You might have a chance to tell that to the Emperor himself. I am escorting you to Silmalaris. I have my orders.
Of course you have your orders, Lorn Knight. That's all you will ever have.
Thank you. trouble.
Thank you.
Are you wounded, Captain?
Scratches. Nothing deep, my general.
Your hair is full of blood.
Yes, it stopped dripping by itself, so it can't be too serious. I'm fine. If I may ask, what was that, General? Are we at war with the Wild?
Not that I knew, no. But I guess we are now. At least, we won't be fighting brothers, like in the Wide South.
The War of the Whispering Stones, wasn't it?
Not really a war, a rebellion. It ended when we brought Markosh back to the throne.
What happened to him?
I don't know. It all went quickly. I was made a general. We were given a house in the officer district of Silmalaris. Then, as quickly as that, I was given my marching orders to Algarak.
Do you think the Empire knew about wild clans in this region?
No. The Empire would have sent us straight at them, and sent us prepared. I don't know, but it looked like someone wanted me far from Silmalaris, as fast as possible.
Yes. Marching 2 days before the celebrations of Orienka. That was rushing it.
I met my wife during the Orienkas. 10 summers ago.
I never really liked them. Too much music and dancing for my taste.
No music?
No. I was only interested in the arcane arts when I was young. It was something I could control, have power over. Most Orienkas, I spent them in my parents' cellar, rehearsing the 49 gestures, training my air influence on our poor cats.
That's how you became a Wind Maiden, joined the army, fought the Gojan Rebellion, and became one of our youngest captains. Yes, I spoke with your temple elder before we left. What he didn't tell me was the mistake you made to end up serving a freshly promoted general promptly banished to the freezing north.
Are you sure you want to know, my general?
Laj could find out, but I'd rather hear it from you, yes.
That's simple. I slept with the wrong person.
One of your men?
A superior.
Your general?
No, his wife.
Oh, well. It had nothing to do with the battlefield, which means I can still trust you with my life. We are good, Captain.
Thank you, my general.
Truth is, we are not that good. Stranded in this snow. Limited supplies, no place to hide. Very little knowledge of what we have on our hands. Let's see what Laj will learn. But it looks like we will need all the trust we can find, Captain.
At least we are far from Silmalaris politics.
Yes, yes. That's something, at least.